Well, welcome to our second bit of wrestling. We will continue with paper two. And like I told you earlier, we are not going to handle all the questions in this paper. I'll only look at a few questions that were most thrilled by most of you. And I'll start with number 10. I'll start, go straight to number 10. Kadri, walk with me. We talk of a question like, a family uses 3,500 ml of milk in the month of July and August, and want to know the number of liters they consume. In this question, there is some missing information, because what I expected is that the 3,500 ml you're talking about should be, this is what is being used in one day. We had this missing information in that question, meaning that in one day, if you multiply this, because you're assuming these want to be three packets each, holding 500 ml, and this gives you a total of 1,500 ml of milk as what they use in the in one day. How about in the month of July and August? Be very keen when you're talking of July and August. And the reason why every examiner will give you the month of July and August is because both these months have 31 days. Unlike other months, where if one has that, the other one has that one. Both July and August have that one, meaning we have a total of 62 days. 62 days, you multiply by 1,500. These are the number of ml this family uses in the 62 days. The examiner does not need the answer in ml, the examiner needs it in liters. And you know very well that 1 liter gives you 1,000 ml. What are you going to do then? You take these all these ml, you divide by 1,000. 0, 0, 0, 0, by 5, 2, by 5, 3, by 2, 1, by 2, 31, 31 times 3 gives you 93 liters. And this is the correct answer that we needed. In the same paper, we go straight to question 13. Question 13 talks of a cylinder. Remember yesterday in our lesson, we talked of a question like this one, where we need the capacity of a tank when it is half full. The height is 1 meter, and we want the capacity in liters when the tank is half full. The key word there is half, and number two, we talk of liters. I told you in such a question, what you're first required to do is to get the volume, then this volume is the one that you change to capacity. How do you get the volume of a cylinder? You will remember very well. I told you that we get the area of the cross section or the base area, or what we call the uniform shape, then you multiply it by the height. This is a circle, we get the area as pi r squared, then you multiply by the height. This gives you 22 over 7 times a radius of 0.4 times another 0.4 times a height of 1, which is remains to be the same. Then you multiply by 1,000. By multiplying by 1,000, I'm changing the volume now into capacity, because we say 1 meter cubed is equal to 1,000 liters. I hope you're following me. Pi r squared times 1,000. And when you work with this one, these two zeros will help you eliminate these decimals. Then by 71 by 71, 22 times 7 gives you 154, times 10 gives you 154. Then we have a zero here, liters. Now, this is the capacity of the tank, don't forget, when it is full. And the examiner needed when it is full. So whatever you have here, you divide by 2. You don't divide by half, you divide by 2. Come to the second, the number 16. Question 16 is a question on time. On one side, this one is a timetable. Here we have the arrival, and here we have the departure. And the question we're interested in, town A and town D. When we come to town A, when you come to town A, you cannot arrive at town A because you're already at town A. Then what time do you depart town A? You depart town A at 8 a.m. Clear to that bit? Then come to town D, which we're interested in. You arrive in town D at 1:15 p.m. and you depart from the same town at 1:30 p.m. Hoping you're together to this. We want to take the time taken. How long does the time does this bus take to travel from town A to town D? So in town A, you're going to take the departure. In town D, you're going to take the arrival. You take the time which you depart. This one is the departure, and this is the arrival. I hope we are together on this. What time do you depart? You depart here at 8 a.m. What do you arrive? You arrive here at 1:15 p.m. Get my words here very well. When we are doing questions on time, we don't use the 12-hour clock system. We use the 24-hour clock system. Change 8 a.m. to 24-hour clock system, it becomes 0800 hours. Change this 1 p.m. to 12-hour clock, 24-hour clock system, you add 12 because it's a p.m. And this gives you 13:15 hours. You have the departure, you have the arrival. To get the time taken, what I'm supposed to take, we take the arrival, which is 13:15 minus 0800. And what you get here? 5:1. 13 minus 8, you get it to be 5. Don't forget, on one side, this one, we have hours. On this other side, we have minutes. Meaning, we take 5 hours, 15 minutes, which can be 5 and a quarter hours. This is what we call the time taken. Get my words very well, I said? On this timetable, when we leave town A, we take the departure. When we come to town D, we take the arrival. Then you take the time you arrive minus the time you started your journey. That's question 16, and I wish that we go straight to question 21. I've told you that I'm going to only look at those questions that were mostly failed. Question 21. There's a question on ratio. I know the ratio is one of the units you have not had the details. But I know we have covered some bit of it with you in the class. And I believe that with this one, with the guidance I'm going to give you here, you're going to get it. We have been mentioned of two people. One is Jane and the other one is Jacqueline. We have been told about this, what we've been told. These people shared money in the ratio of 3:4. Jane atichukua 3, Jacqueline anachukua 4. If Jane picks 300, Jane takes 400, Jacqueline takes 400. Then, if Jacqueline got 3,000 more than Jane, 3,000 more than Jane, listen to this. That, of course, this is 4 and this is 3. We expect that Jacqueline got more. The difference in their ratio is 1. The year total here is 7. This is what we say, that the difference is what made Jacqueline made more than get more than Jane. We will say, if one, this one here which represents the difference, is creating a difference of 3,000. What about, in case you are asked about Jane who gets your result, what about 3? Will that be then you cross multiply? If you had been asked about Jacqueline, you would have done the same thing. If one is equivalent to 3,000, what about Jacqueline? 4. It has presented that P. Again, you cross multiply. We now want maybe the total. What do you do? You do the same thing. If 1 is equal to 3,000, what about the total? Total is 3 plus 4, giving you 7. 7. But you're happy. You just cross multiply. And so the question was asking, how much money were they sharing? How much money were they sharing? They were sharing the total. And so this is the best comparison you have used to arrive at the correct answer. I hope you have understood that. It's very simple. When we get more time, I believe, we'll look at similar questions of that type. You can also use your primary maths. There are so many questions of that type. Try do 2, 3, or 4. Send me the answers, and then I'll check for you whether you are right. Question 23. Question 23 reads, a tank was 3/4 full of water. Write this, a tank was 3/4 full. Sorry. When 60 liters were drawn and kutoa, wakati tulitoa 60 liters, it became a half full. We already have a new question. 2/3/4F minus 60 is equals to 1.5. Sorry, is equals to half full. Put the right terms together. This half, you bring it to this other side. E minus 60, you take it to this other side. I told you, when we are moving, we normally consider two things. One, tuna move ile dogo, ama ile ikona, a negative side. And so what are we going to have? We have 3/4F minus 1/2F is equals to 60 liters. 3 quarter minus a half, everyone will tell you that the quarter F is equals to 60. I need F, which represents full. So this side you multiply by 4 over 1, and this side by 4 over 1. 1, 1, 4, 4. F for full is equals to 240 meters. What's the question asking? The question is asking a very simple question. What is the capacity of the tank? What is the capacity of the tank? The capacity of the tank is 240 liters. Number 24, please, is a question on scale drawing. This one is a question on scale drawing. In scale drawing, we consider two things. We compare statements on a piece of paper representing some information which is on the ground. Understood? Here you have been told the scale is 1:40,000. If 1 centimeter on a piece of paper represents 40,000 centimeters on the ground, understand this very well. If 1 centimeter on a paper represents 40,000 centimeters on the ground, what is the actual length in kilometers represented by 6 centimeters? What about 6 centimeters? It represents centimeters gapi. But we don't want it in centimeter. Remember, the examiner needs it in kilometers. I hope you're following me. You just multiply. 6 times 4 gives you 24. With how many zeros? 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. What are these? Centimeters. We want the distance in kilometers. The distance to change centimeters into kilometers, we divide by 100,000. How many zeros are these? 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, and 0. 24 divided by 10 becomes 2.4 kilometers. 2.4 kilometers. These are the statements on the piece of paper. We call it the drawing measurement. And the statement on the ground, the measurement on the ground, we call it real or actual measurement. Or actual measurement. Very good. This is what we have. You compare some measurements on a piece of paper representing some information which is on the ground. Around me, move from number 24 and I go straight to question 30. Question 30. Katie, question 30. Work with me. Work with me for question 30. And thank my cameraman to turn the camera towards me now. Question 30. Question 30. Hoping you are together. Are we there? Hope you're there. Good. Thank you. When an item is sold at 1,850, when an item is sold at 1,850 shillings, we are being told a loss of 7.5 is made. Hey, if you sell anything at a loss, means you've sold it at less than 100%. If the loss is 7.5, you are going to take 100, we subtract 5. If we subtract this, you get it as 92.5%. So that means 1,850 is equivalent to 92.5%. Understood? Then the question comes, how much should he sell? You sell at 92, the price is 1,850. The question is, how much should you sell it to make a profit of 15%? I told you, for it to be a loss, it must be less than 100. If it is a profit, it must be more than 100. How many loss you subtract? If it is profit, you add. So to get a profit of 15 means that you sell it at 115%. I hope you are getting me. This one truly indicates that this was a loss and this is a profit. Loss of 7.5, you take 100 minus 7.5, you get it to be 92.5. To get a profit, you take the 100, you subtract 15. And so, utasema, if 1,850 is equivalent to 92.5%, how much is 115? You just cross multiply. This gives you 1,850. You multiply by 115% or over 92.5%. There's something I want you to guide you on this one. To eliminate this decimal, multiply this one by 10, it disappears. And here, when you multiply by 10, you add another 0. I hope you're together. I've just multiplied by 10 here and multiplied by 10 there. Then you simplify this one and you pay the same price. That's what I needed of you. From question 34, so from question 30, I beg that we all move to question 41. I told you that I'm only going to look at those questions that were mostly filled. Question 41 is a question on HPP, higher purchase price. When you're dealing with higher purchase price, boys and girls, we said that you pay some little amount of money, which we call the deposit, then the rest you pay in what we call monthly installments. What does this mean? In a certain number of months, you pay a certain amount. Like 10 months, you pay 2,000 shillings. That's what we call monthly installments. And this is what gives you HPP, higher purchase price. This is number 41 in assembly. The higher purchase price of a generator is 32,000. The HPP is 32,000. The information which you have been given here, put it in the formula. Ochieng paid 8,000 as the deposit and paid the rest in monthly installments. Listen to this. At this, somebody by the name Ochieng paid a deposit of 8,000, of course, plus what we call the monthly installments, and this is what made this person pay 32,000. The monthly installments were for 1 year. Remember, we are talking of months, and here we are talking of a year. So we are talking of 12 months. Meaning that this one he paid for 12 months. This balance here, he paid it in 12 months. So how are we going to get this one? Unataka kujua kwanza, he 12 months and get a pesa ngapi. You take this 8,000 to this other side, you subtract 8,000. And what are we going to get? 00042. So for 12 months, he paid a total of 24,000. How about 1 month? You divide by 12 and you divide by 12. 1 month he paid by 12, 2,000. So 2,000 shillings is what we call installments. This is what you pay every year. Sorry, this is what you pay every month. I said deposit plus monthly installment is equal to HPP. A deposit of 8,000 plus 12 months gives you 32,000. You take this 8,000 to the other side, you subtract it, becomes 24,000. For 12 months, you pay 24. What about 1 month? Because the question is key. How much was each installment? How much was 1 month? Number 42. Even one of you has a question on what I'm covering, feel free to reach me on my page. The bus fare from Kajiado to Isinya increased. This one is ratio. And one thing I want you to know about ratio is that it is one question. You must receive a question. From this topic in your KCP paper. The price increased from, I want you to understand this one, from 1,000 shillings to 125 shillings. From 100 to 125. And the question is asking, what was the ratio increase? What was the ratio increase? Whenever we are dealing with questions on ratio, we use a simple formula called NO. This stranger, NO. NO represents new is to old. You compare the new price with the old price. The new price is, if it was 100 and now it is 200, 125, which is the new price? Of course, this one. So the new is 125 is to the old price, which is 100. Second rule in scale drawing. Other than using the NO, scale must be written, ratio must be written in its simplest form. Is it possible for you to simplify 125 and 100? Yes. This we have a common factor, like 5. If you divide here by 5, you get 25. Divide here by 5, you get 20. Divide by 5, you get 5. Divide by 5, you get 4. Very good. This is the first. You cannot go beyond that. So when you're dealing with the ratio, I said you use the pattern of NO. New is to old. The new is 125. The old is 100. Then you simplify 125 and 100. You simplify that and you get it to be 5 is 2 or 4. Very good. Having gone to that question 42, I beg that we all now turn to question 46. Question 46. I hope you're there. There's another question, and I'll still mention something about it. Because earlier I told you about calendar, and even here I'll repeat the same. This is a question on calendar. I beg that you work with me. How many days are there from 19? Hey, again, we are back to the same question. From 19 December 2015 to 20th March. Be very keen. This is the last question I'm going to ask. Of course, it is the following year. Now, if this was 2015, you don't have to be told that this was 2016. 2016 is divisible by 4, and so it is a leap year. Are we together? Come to this question. What do you do? List down the months mentioned. We have the month of December 2015. This in December don't change. Then we have the month of January, we have the month of February, and we have the month of March. List down the number of days in these months. Come to the month of January, it has 31. Come to the month of February, in a leap year, it is supposed to have 29 days. The month of March has 31. And in December, we all know it has 31. Get to that bit? We want from 19, kutoka 19. Whether we need 19, 20, 21, 22, up to 31. So I'll ask you a simple question. In the month of December, how many days? Because we are counting from 19. So we don't need these other days, meaning we don't need 18 days. So what I'm going to do, you are going to take the 31, you subtract the 18, which we don't need. And so what I'm going to add, in the month of December, you're only going to have 30 days. How do you get arrived at these 30? We are saying we are starting from 19. Count with me. 19, 20th, 21st, 22nd, 23rd, 24th, 25th, 26th, 27th, 28th, 29th, 30, and 31. That's why we're having 13 days. There they are. Then come to the whole month of January and February. And at this one, you are going to get it at 60. Then when we come to March, we need up to 20th. Up to 20th. We don't need the rest of the days. We only need 20 days. You will sum up this one, you get this one as 3, then this one as 93 days. Be very, very keen when you are solving, when you are working out these questions. We'll be very keen when you're working out these questions. And the very, very last one questions I'm going to look at is a question which is very simple. A ratio of 3:4. You have been taught to recreate this one as a percentage. It is the simplest thing ever. If it is 3:4, change this one into a fraction. It becomes 3/4. To change anything, whether ratio, whether fraction, whether decimal, to a percentage, you multiply by 100. You simplify this one by 4. 1 by 4, you get 25. 25 times 3 gives you 75%. That's how you change this scale ratio into a percentage. And I beg that up to that bit, today I've only gone specifically to the questions that were mostly failed. Good boys and girls, if you want to go far, go to your made KCP made for media. Choose similar questions and make sure you do at least 2 in every subtopic. Thank you so much and may God bless you.